here we go. Test flight. The 6x4.5 inch props are on the Mobius little bouncy wobbly clean plate mount, whatever they call it, is on. The CC3D board is not configured for this new prop setup, but I'm just going to go for it anyway. It should still be flyable, I would think. This battery, it is a 3-cell 1800 milliamp, not fully charged. It is pulling 12 volts at the moment, but it's close enough for what I want to do. We'll soon know whether it works or not as regards the flight time. So I can power it on in here. Yeah, I'm pretty sure this is still set up. I am a little bit concerned about how close the props are. It's not gonna hit, but it's not ideal. If I had some tape, I'd tape that down. Come inside there, I suppose, just to hold it. Alright, that holds it a bit better. Look, it's down to 3.97, I haven't been anywhere. Alright, I lost 0.1 of a volt just sitting on the tabletop. It's kind of weird. Right, no, that should be okay. Let's go test it. battery's warm, but not excessively. Motors are stone cold. ESC's cold. This is looking better. 3.75. Right, that first test was slightly inconclusive because I didn't time it for one. I was playing around with that low voltage alarm for two, and my neighbours were both in their back garden, so I couldn't talk to myself like a crazy person without them calling the local hospital and have me carried away. So what I'm going to do, I think I've reset that low voltage. That is really loud, this thing. I've set it, it was under power, it keeps coming on, that's why it was beeping like mad. So the voltage is dropping below a certain level. I've reset it to a bit lower, which I shouldn't really do. But I will time this flight and I'll try and get, well, I'll do each of the batteries in turn. I've got a 1.3, 1.5 and an 1800, all similar kind of C ratings. And we'll see what sort of flight times I get with all of those. See if I can find an optimum one. I'm pretty sure it was flying better than last time. It certainly held the air better. I wasn't having to fiddle with the throttle so much. If I held the throttle in mid-stick, it was pretty, I don't know, it just kind of held its own position. Not like before, it just kind of dropped all of a sudden. So definitely better, and I will go and bash these through. All of these I think are fully charged. Those two definitely are. I'm not sure about the 1800 one. I'll soon find out when I'll plug this in and see what sort of flight times I get. Let's go. Alright, the second battery, which is at 3.8, the voltage alarm was going like crazy, and I think this is a low burst rate on it. 25, I mean that one, it's 25 to 35, but better. That one is just, it's definitely on the burst rate isn't helping these things. I think that's the problem. The props are definitely helping. But yeah, these batteries aren't specific. Oh, they're not good either. Okay, I need to get that one off. He's pretty warm, to say the least. I'll try this last one. It's getting too windy. It's really getting buffeted around, but even so, I'm not impressed with the flight time still. So, plan B is the fact that these the discharge rate, I mean, that 1300 milliamp was, that did pretty well. I could have got a lot further than 5 minutes that I did. 3.79, right, let's put this one in as a test as well. And then I've got some new batteries coming, hopefully they'll be here shortly, so I can use those. I've got a much higher burst rate on them. But for now, I'm not sure if this will fit on or not. Right, it's not fully charged again, but it will do for testing purposes. Let's see if I can get 5 minutes with it. Right, hot battery, 11, 3.6, 3.7, 3.72, and it went down from 4. That's similar. Ooh, let's get this off. Warm again. I just put another one of these 1500s through and it lasted for 1 minute 20 on these 6 inch props. So this is the actual one. Let's see what sort of voltage I'm getting. Just died in the air. It's still showing as 12. That's weird. Just no power going to it and it just kind of plummeted out the ground. So somewhere, is it a setting on the CC3D board that's killing it? It could well be the power distribution board. It's sapping the energy somehow. It's a bit of fancy, that distribution board. So camera's cool, immersion RC is pretty cool. Motors are always stone cold. Strange. See, it's showing now at 4. That wouldn't go in the air with that. It did initially and then it just got kind of ground down. But still plenty of voltage on there. That's weird. So then it's two batteries. Initially I did this one first and I got a rubbish flight time, so I know I've damaged one of these, or I thought I had. So I put a second one on, which is this one here, which is identical. And I got 1 minute. They are rubbish make. I've had these a long time, so that can't be helping. But those are 25C. The best results I've got with this 1.3 Turnagy, which was a 25-35 discharge. The other one was the, which I don't have handy now. Oh, it's in the fridge. I still want the, that was the other one I was using, and that wasn't a bad flight time. However, again, giving off a lot of heat, it's only 20C rating. That's weird, I'm not sure what's going on. Something is draining it. I don't know if it's because of the C rating or because something somewhere is draining the power from this. Probably have to wait for my new set of batteries. It was really windy as well. It was blustery, and it didn't like it in the wind. Wasn't bad considering, but hovering round in the tight confines of the garden, it's not the smartest thing to do. The settings, it seemed okay. It didn't seem bad with these 6-inch props. So I don't know. I don't need to reconfigure the CC3D board because you can easily fly it with those settings if I can stay in the air long enough, more than 1:28. However, at some point I will need to reconfigure these, the CC board for these 6-inch props, just to dial it in a bit better. But it seemed okay to me. It was just a little bit jittery, but again, I think that was to do with the wind. So I'm a little bit disappointed now, because that thing will have to go on the back burner whilst I wait for the new batteries to come. I've got four higher burst rate, I think the 15s. Yeah, 1500 milliamp 3 cells. Yeah, it's kind of depressing, that. That's weird. I just can't think what is drawing the power so much, to a point where it was as though the CC board cut out then. I'll have another look at the settings for the CC3D board, see if there's anything on there where you can adjust the voltages, or I don't know. That's weird. That is weird. Right, I have no idea what's wrong with this. It could be a number of factors. I've eliminated the props. And to be honest, when I put the 5x4s on, they were recommended with this kind of setup. The 6 ones, the 6 inches, definitely gave better flight time. Better lift, better control, so I probably will go with these 6 inches regardless anyway. The motors were cool, the ESCs were cool, the immersion video transmitter was plugged in this time, and it always gets fairly warm, but nothing horrific. The batteries were getting hot once again. Some of the batteries, they seem to be cutting out for whatever reason, I don't know. It just, the power drained away from them really quickly, and when I got the voltage meter on them, they were still showing a fair amount of voltage charge left in them. So I'm not sure what's going on with that. I'm not sure at all. I don't know whether the CC3D board has some kind of voltage limiting reading, but I'm not even going through there with the power. The only thing going through there are the motors, so maybe, I don't know. I need to go read up on the CC3D board. At the back of my mind, one thing I've noticed are these highest C ratings that I do have. They are, even though it's a smaller battery, they do seem to be working better, which would suggest that it is a C rating issue. These motors are, I mean, these are good motors. These are the old T motors on there. I'm just wondering if they are, they must be genuine ones. I'm thinking of if I've bought some knockoff ones. Certainly wasn't at a knockoff price, because I'm pretty sure they're genuine. They feel genuine. The build quality of them looks pretty genuine. Weird. I have got some others, but some Cobra motors, similar spec to these, but it means a lot of desoldering and resoldering. And I don't really want to use that option. I just want to use the option where you flick a switch and it seems to all work again. Sadly, I don't think that's going to happen. One thing again at back of my mind is, so the options are things to change out the motors, possibly the ESCs. If I do the motors, I'll do the ESCs as well, just as a matter of course. But I'm pretty sure the ESCs are fine, and I'm pretty sure the motors are fine, to be honest. I can't do anything with the batteries yet because I have no replacements. They are in the post on the way to me. I'll do a bit of research on the CC3D board. Again, I don't think there is anything on the software diagnostics to limit the voltage or any calibration, whether it's 3-cell, 4-cell. That's a real long shot as to whether that'll work. The only other thing at the back of my mind is this power distribution board is maybe, I don't know, it's maybe sipping my power, but I mean that would get really hot. If it was drawing the power through that distribution board, then you would think the power would have to come out of there via heat, so, and that board is not getting hot at all. So I've no idea where that power drain is going. Weird. Very weird indeed. I'm going to have to take this apart anyway and do some rewiring. I need to get another soldering iron, or another two soldering irons. I always end up getting two as backup. So I'll go out tomorrow and get a couple of soldering irons. And I guess I'm going to have to take... I really don't want to. After getting it all together... these little small screws, I think those are 2.5 millimeter screws on there, and they just round off. You can see that one sticking up still. These small gauge threaded 2.5 millimeters soft metals, they just round off straight away, so I can see myself having a real fight with those to get them out. Oh, that's going to be gnarly as well, trying to get those off underneath the Mobius. And maybe squeeze it in there. Yeah, I can probably do that. So yeah, there we are. Disappointingly, I thought this would be up and running by now. But it's nowhere near. I've got 5 minutes with the this one. A better quality battery. Those other ones are cheaper as mine. I mean, those are both made by Johnny Smith or someone. I don't know. They're real cheaps. And they're quite old, these now. Especially those. And those look to be puffed up a little bit. So maybe it is a battery issue. So I think a flight on this one has been stalled whilst I'm going to have to wait for the batteries, I think. I'm going to go and check to see if there's any notification as to where they are in the world. And I just know they take forever to come from, I think it's China. Could be Hong Kong, which seemed to send them quicker, but... I'm kind of stuck until those arrive. There's no point stripping it all down, only to find out that it still doesn't work when I put the new batteries on. So there we go, that concludes my HoverThings Flip 260. It looks good, it actually flies. I'm looking forward to flying it. It's quite twitchy. It was very windy out there, but I've flown it on some calmer days, and it was for the time, or short time it was in the air, it was quite good fun. It doesn't hold its altitude very well, which is another thing with these batteries, possibly. Yeah, we'll see. I'm leaning towards the battery being no good, or not up to the task. Not many, no. So there we have it. Disappointingly, a half-hearted attempt at maidening this thing, and it's still, I officially don't call that a maiden until it actually goes somewhere outside the back garden.